Director General, Excellencies, the theme of this year's assembly, Health for Peace, Peace for Health, could not be more relevant. Right at this moment while we are holding our meeting, Russia continues its brutal assault on our neighbor, Ukraine. And while Russian Federation is a member state of the WHO, it continues immoral, criminal, shameful, and deliberate attacks on Ukrainian people and Ukrainian health system. It has already destroyed 100 hospitals and about 500 other health facilities. More than 230 Ukrainian children have been killed, more than 400 wounded. It is enough. It must be stopped right now. Latvia fully aligns with the position of the European Union. We condemn the Russian military aggression against Ukraine. We demand that Russia immediately ceases military action, that it unconditionally respects Ukraine's territorial integrity, sovereignty, and independence within its internationally recognized borders. We appeal in the strongest possible terms to the Russian Federation as the member of the WHO to immediately stop assaults on healthcare facilities and medical staff, to allow the evacuation of civilians, to ensure and respect humanitarian corridors with necessary ceasefire assurances, and to ensure free and safe access for those delivering medical and humanitarian assistance. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm grateful for valuable work that WHO has done in Ukraine already and plans to do in the near future. On May 10th, the Regional Committee for Europe held a special session on the health emergency in Ukraine and requested the Director General to report upon it to this Assembly. I look forward to the DG's report, and I am sure it will highlight the commitment of WHO to protect and save Ukrainian health system and Ukrainian people's fundamental right to health. Excellencies, the direct and indirect impact of the humanitarian catastrophe caused by the Russian Federation's aggression stems well beyond Ukraine and well beyond the European region. I'm truly grateful to many countries that have selflessly provided medical aid to Ukraine beyond and above their capabilities, including Latvia. I urge all member states to continue this effort and to step it up. We can always do more to alleviate the suffering of people in Ukraine. And beyond Ukraine, Latvia praises the WHO for its work to alleviate human suffering which is caused by wars and conflicts in other regions like Afghanistan, Syria, Ethiopia, for its tireless efforts undertaken in very complex and dangerous settings, in commitment of the fundamental clause of the WHO Constitution. The health of all people is fundamental to the attainment of peace and security. Finally, I wish to thank the WHO and its country office for all their tireless and valuable support to Latvia, for the continuous sharing of knowledge, expertise, and support that has been invaluable for overcoming challenges caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, for building and improving our health care. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to speak to you here today. Thank you.